The Child Abuse Royal Commission has delivered damning proof George Pell turned a blind eye to paedophile priests. Abuse survivors welcomed the long-awaited report, but late today, the Cardinal issued a statement disputing the findings. More from Brett McLeod.
He should have known and he would have known. That, in short, is what the Royal Commission had to say about George Pell's knowledge of clerical abuse.
It probably affected me a little bit more today than what I expected to.
For abuse survivors like Stephen Blacker, relief that the hidden section of the report is now in public, detailing a conspiracy of silence.
It's not just one or two people that withheld this information. It's a much wider group.
Most of the previously redacted sections are about George Pell's dealings with two of the church's most abusive priests, Gerald Ridsdale and Peter Searson. In evidence to the commission, Pell denied any knowledge of allegations against Ridsdale until 1993. He'd only heard what he dismissed as gossip.
It's a sad story and it wasn't of much interest to me.
But the commission found as early as the 1970s, child abuse was on George Pell's radar. Promoted by concerns over Gerald Ridsdale taking boys on overnight camps. By 1973, Cardinal Pell was not only conscious of child sexual abuse by clergy, but has also considered measures of avoiding situations which might provoke gossip about it. Pell was at a 1982 meeting with Ballarat Bishop Mulkerns, where it was decided Ridsdale had to be moved specifically because of complaints he had sexually abused children. Evidence the commissioners found, Pell knew of Ridsdale's sexual transgressions long before Ridsdale first faced court. They also criticised the Cardinal over failures involving Father Peter Searson, whose vile crimes included sexual assault, killing animals in front of children and threatening two teenage girls with a knife. Pell claimed he was deceived by others about the extent of Searson's offending. The commission found that implausible. We do not accept that then Bishop Pell was deceived, intentionally or otherwise. It was incumbent on Bishop Pell, with responsibilities for the welfare of children, to take such action as he could to advocate that Father Searson be removed or suspended. Searson went on to attack other children and died without facing justice.
Time and again, while giving evidence under oath, George Pell said there was a conspiracy of senior figures in the church to stop him knowing the extent of abuse, and in fact, he was the victim of a cover-up. The commission said they don't believe him.
None of it's a surprise. He was very evasive and untruthful in everything he put towards the Royal Commission. Even though he swore on his Bible, so that just shows what a type of person he is.
And for abuse survivors, today brings vindication.
Having 20/20 vision, looking back, we see that there are so many missed opportunities to protect children.
The report doesn't criticise Pell in isolation, but also the church hierarchy, particularly former Archbishop Little and Bishop Mulkerns, who worked to protect the archdiocese from scandal and liability and prioritised the interests of the church over those of the victims. As to his own conduct, Pell told the commission, "I should have done more." On that, the commissioners are in furious agreement. Brett McLeod, Nine News.
Court reporter Eliza Rugg is outside St Patrick's Cathedral. Eliza, how has the Cardinal responded?
Pete, the Cardinal has made it very clear that he believes the Royal Commission has got it wrong. His media team has released a statement on his behalf and it reads, Cardinal Pell said he was surprised by some of the views of the Royal Commission about his actions. These views are not supported by evidence. But lawyers for complainants of clergy abuse say that the findings will kickstart a number of civil claims. People who were let down by the church when they were children in the worst possible way.
Once they are heard, believed, and then their trauma is recognised in the form of a monetary payment, it's incredibly empowering for those clients.
As for criminal charges against Pell, they've been described as unlikely but possible. Providing false or misleading evidence to a royal commission, that is an indictable offence. Pete.
Eliza Rugg reporting.